to another video. Today I will try to draw something on this surface. This blackboard or chalkboard. Draw something on this. So I'm quite excited to see how this will turn out. And I couldn't try earlier because it wasn't until today that I found this in a shop close to where I live. The right type of chalk and I will try to draw some stars in the sky, because lately I have been quite interested in the night sky and the stars and the constellations. Try to learn to recognize some constellations and some bright stars. And one way to learn is to prepare and record videos, and also trying to teach others while I'm still learning. Some sketching. This was a couple of weeks ago when I tried to memorize some of the stars. And I also have a print. Start with the star Polaris. But we have always visible here in Sweden. It's located above the North Pole. So if the sky is clear, if it's a starry night, then you should be able to see Polaris. It's not so bright though, but it's organization that Polaris is a part of is the constellation the Little Bear, also called the Little Dipper. So it's this rectangular shape. Recognizable shape is this rectangular. And if this is the Little Dipper, we will also find the Big Dipper here somewhere. Actually, I think this gap between those constellations is a lot wider, but I wanted to fit into this frame, so I put it here today. Big Dipper. That is part of bigger constellation called the Big or Greater Bear. And then if you think about this, think of this as a bear, then this should be the tail. And we have the legs. I guess a Big Dipper is one of the first constellations you learn to recognize, at least if you're in the northern hemisphere. I think there are some stars between these constellations, and that's the stars of the dragon. The dragon with its head here. Something like that. And I tried to learn some of these stars, the name of some of these stars. And I think one of these are called Deneb. Or no. I think it's called Dupe. I just remember it started with a T, so it's Dupe. I think it might be this one. And another one of these stars is called Aliot. All these stars are quite prominent stars, and they all have names, like old names. Not just a combination of letters and numbers, they have like, they are named. But I just remember Tupé and Aliot. And the opposite side of Polaris, the North Celestial Pole, you know, the sky is rotating around Polaris. So Polaris isn't rotating at all, but the sky rotates like this. We have the constellation Cassiopeia. And I think I have to check on my print here exactly how it's located. Actually, I'll check this one. Okay, so Polaris. Maybe here. I'll put it here. And then we have four stars. This is also a really recognizable shape, I think. Also here in the north, we see this every starry night. It's like a W shape, like a stretched out W, so it's like very wide. And this is the Cassiopeia constellation. Cassiopeia was a princess, I guess. Or a queen, maybe? Yeah, the queen it was, in Greek mythology. There are a lot of Greek myths about the animals and the people who had given the names for these constellations. Cassiopeia was a queen, married to the king Cepheus, and Cepheus also has his constellation here somewhere. And the Cepheus constellation looks like a house, I think. And I'll put it here. Square for the house and triangle for the use this map I'm drawing here to navigate or something, because I know it's there are a lot of errors here. So I'm still learning. Somewhere here we should have the sign, or I mean the constellation, called Andromeda. Andromeda was a princess in the Greek myths. Actually, the daughter of Cassiopeia and Cepheus. And when I look at the sky, I try to recognize Andromeda together with the constellation Pegasus. And together they make a really big constellation that I think it reminds me of actually the Big Dipper and Small Dipper. So it's like a tail with consisting of three or four stars. I never learn how many, but let's say it's three stars. And then we have the square here. Big square. And the square is actually the Pegasus constellation. And this tail is Andromeda. And it's actually like two tails, or what you should call them, parallel like this. I think it looked really nice, this constellation, this pair of constellations. And there are some more stars here. I'm not sure exactly how this is supposed to be looking like a princess, but there are also this interesting object here. I don't think I have seen it with the naked eye, but it's located here somewhere, the Andromeda galaxy, our closest galaxy. Neighbor galaxy. Very fascinating that you actually can see this in the sky. So what do we have next? Yeah, we have the hero from the Greek mythology that rescued Andromeda from the sea monster Cetus. It was called the sea monster. And hero was called Perseus, and his constellation is located here somewhere. And I don't know how as a shrimp. It's like three something stars here, and then there are a lot of less brighter stars quite close to each other during this curve here. I don't know, I think it reminds me of a shrimp. Anyway, then there are some stars in this direction. My version of Perseus constellation. And we have one bright star here. It's called Merfak. And we have another bright star here somewhere, I think. Mentioned that this was our neighbor galaxy, and our own galaxy, the Milky Way, can actually be seen in the sky, at least when it's starry nights and not so many disturbing lights surrounding you. And it goes located across the sky like this. I think Perseus is located in the same direction as the Milky Way, and also Cassiopeia. So this is supposed to be the Milky Way. Consisting of a lot of small stars that you cannot separate from other with the naked eye. So it's just light area in the sky. Charioteer here somewhere. I hope I used the right word now, but I think it's like a heptagon. the charioteer. And one of these stars is actually a really bright star, Capella. One of the brightest stars in the sky. I think it could be the fifth brightest star. Maybe the sixth. Not quite sure. And connecting to the charioteer, we have the Taurus. Consisting of a lot of small, not so bright stars, but they're very close. Close together. Also called, this cluster of stars is also called the Hyades. Hyades, maybe. And that's part of the Taurus constellation. See that shape in this star cluster as well, so it's really small. It could maybe be called the Tiny Dipper or Tiny Bear, but it's called the Pleiades, and I think in Greek mythology the Pleiades were seven sisters that were transformed into birds, I think, and then put to the sky by the gods, and the Hyades were also sisters. Were related somehow, Hyades and Pleiades. And we have the zodiac. Taurus is part of the zodiac. It's a sign, astrological sign. The zodiac. Which the moon and the sun and all the planets in our solar system follows this path. You can always find it here somewhere. And it's also where we have the 12 signs. So it's Taurus. We have Aries. Sorry, we have the twins first. Two bright stars that you recognize. That you can recognize. It's Castor and Pollux. Two twins in the Greek myths. And the These are the heads of these twins. I never learned which one is Castor and which one is Pollux. But that's just how it used to be when it's about twins, isn't it? And here we have the rest of this constellation. And here we have Cancer, the crab. Those stars are not bright at all. I almost haven't seen them, I think. Not recently, when I tried to locate some stars in the sky. And then we have the lion, Leo. Stars. I think this one is Regulus. This one is called Algiba. And this is just the head of the lion, so the body is in this direction. There are some minor constellations with no bright stars at all, and I don't think I ever have seen them, so I haven't learned them either. And in this direction we should have the Swan. Cygnus, I think it's called, also from Greek myths, Cygnus, who tried to rescue his friend from the bottom of a river, or I think it was a river. Swan, so he could rescue his friend. And Cygnus constellation is also called the Northern Cross. There are the Southern Cross on the Southern Hemisphere and the Northern Cross on the Northern Celestial Hemisphere. So here Cygnus is flying also in the Milky Way. I actually noticed from old drawing that this was a bit wrong. I think the roof should be in this direction. So. The Cepheus house. There's still room for some constellations here. I just have to remember those. It's a constellation called Bootes, but it's far this direction, so it's not visible here on this frame. But then we have Hercules here somewhere, and Lyra. Yeah, I think Lyra is probably here. I put the really bright star Vega here. So Lyra is almost just Vega, and then a couple of not so bright stars like this. And Hercules. Sure exactly how it looks. I haven't seen this constellation so many times. I'm not sure when I did it last time. These are more to the south, I think. So here in the north there are most often these stars that you see. And also Orion, another constellation in this direction that I couldn't fit into this map. And we have the Arrow, little constellation here. I think the dolphin should be here somewhere as well. Small constellation. And one of the bright stars in the Cygnus sign is called Deneb. I guess it's this one in the middle. So we have Polaris, and we have Dupe. Sorry, this is Algol in the constellation of Perseus, Algol, and this one is called Aliot. Merfak, the brightest star in Perseus constellation. Cassiopeia, don't know any of these names. Cepheus, no bright star in Cepheus, so I don't remember any name. I don't know if they have, like, old names. Andromeda Galaxy. Alpheratz, I think this one is called, that connects Andromeda to Pegasus. Star in the Cygnus constellation. This was the Big Dipper. Small Dipper. And here we have Capella. Charioteer constellation. Here we have Castor and Pollux, or Castor and Pollux, two bright stars in Gemini, or the twins. Zodiac, Taurus, the bull, one of these stars are actually quite a bright star, not sure which, but I'll for now put it here, it's Aldebaran. Hyades, Pleiades, Aries, Crab, and the Lion, Regulus, and Algiba. This was just one part of the sky, as many as I could fit into this frame. But these are the stars that I see most often when I try to some stars in the sky. Thank you so much.